Now on the Mac we have a dictionary app and it's easy to use it to look up words. On iOS it doesn't appear to be any default dictionary app, but there is a dictionary built in. Of course you can also download one of many third party dictionary apps if you want to use that. But if you want to use the built in dictionary there are a few ways to get to it. For instance, say you're at a web page like this one and you want to look up a word. So you can easily do that by tapping on the word to select it. So I'll select this word here, and then one of the things that appears in the toolbar above the selection is Lookup. And I could tap that and it will bring up the dictionary definition for that word. It will bring up some other results as well, but I can get to the rest of the dictionary definition by tapping on it. And you can see it even says dictionary at the top and it gives you some information there. Now what if you don't see the word? What if it's not there on a web page? Well, you can simply type the word and then bring up the definition based on that. So for instance, I've created a note here, and in this note I could simply type the word theory here and I'm going to select it. So I'm going to select my own word that I typed and I can hit look up and I get the same thing. So I can look up the definition. And you can see sometimes you get a longer entry than other times. Now you can also just search directly for the word. So say you're here on the home screen. I'm going to swipe down, and this is an iOS 11. I'm going to swipe down from the middle and I'm going to type the word I want to look up. And I'm going to get tons of results. So there it appears in notes, Safari, music, there's going to be movies, websites, everything. And eventually I'll get the dictionary and I can tap that and go to the dictionary definition. Now a really clever way to get directly to the definition is to do space and then define. And I find you can just type DEF and it jumps right to it. But notice at the bottom there it even sometimes gives that as a suggestion, theory definition. So either way you want to do it, define, definition, or DEF, you can get to the entry there. So it's pretty easy to get into it. Now you can make it even easier if you go into settings, and under settings you go into Siri and search. So here is where Siri and search is found, right there. And you can determine what shows up. And one of the things you can turn off here are suggestions and lookup. So when you type lookup, you press that little lookup button, instead of getting all that stuff, you're really only going to get definitions now. So let's take a look at that. And if I tap there and I hit lookup, you can see it really just gives me the definitions. I still have the ability to search the web there, but I can go right to the definition. And I had the ability to also customize search there as well. I can turn things off. So if I don't want to see maps, for instance, you saw there was a list of apps there, I could turn off the appearance of maps in results. So you can kind of customize what appears there. Now notice that I've got manage dictionaries here. I'm going to tap that and this will then take me into settings, into general, and into dictionary. And here you could customize exactly what appears, which dictionaries appear. So you can see it's not just a simple, this is the iOS dictionary and that's it. You have a lot of options, including some options that will translate things for you. So you can go ahead and customize and see what you want there. So there are a lot of great ways to look up dictionary definitions in iOS on your iPhone or your iPad without having a third-party app. And the good news is that it's been announced that in iOS 12 Thesaurus will be added as well to this, which will be a welcome addition especially for writers. Thank you.